Hello, hello, everyone. Welcome back to another episode of .NET MAUI 101. In this episode, we're going to look at dynamic resources, which allow you to change your styles and resources and colors during runtime of your .NET MAUI application. So in .NET MAUI, you can work with two types of resources, static resources and dynamic resources. The main difference is that with static resources, it will only be evaluated once. So whenever the application runs, it will find that style, it will put it on the visual element that you're viewing, and then it's done. It's not going to touch it again, even if you're going to change the resource values at runtime. But then we have dynamic resources, and that will not just show you the resource once, but it will also be notified whenever the resources get changed on runtime. With that, you can implement things like dynamic theme changes inside of your application. Without further ado, let's just jump into Visual Studio and see what it's all about. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022. If you've seen some other videos about styles, then you might see something familiar by now. I'm setting the colors to fuchsia because that is my favorite color. This is just a file new .NET MAUI template that you get out of the box. The only thing I kind of added is here in the resources, a resource dictionary with a style, a explicit style, because I'm setting the X key here. And if we want to apply this style, we have to do so by setting the style on this actual control. So there we have that. And now I abstracted away my color here as well. You can set the color here directly. I can here say fuchsia, and it will just use that. But if I want to kind of like show you how to work with these static and dynamic resources, I'm going to abstract that color here to this color node right here. You can put that in your dictionary as well. And then I can set the value to static resource my color. Again, this is set through the key right here. Now, what I also did, so this is set to a static resource. What I also did is under the button, there is a button in this template by default. So the click me right here. And if I go to my main page, you can see that under the clicked method, I added a little thing here and I'm setting resources. This is something that lives in kind of like every page, even on the application level, because you can work with styles and resources on all kinds of levels. And I'm setting these resources, my color, this is the key that we set for our color. I'm setting that to color red. Now, whenever I'm running this with a static resource, like I just said, nothing is going to change, right? It will just be fuchsia and nothing is going to change. But if I'm going to change this to a dynamic resource, so let me just do that right now. I'm going to change this to a dynamic resource, and save that and run the application again. Now you should see that whenever I click the button, it should update the color of my label to red. Now this is just a very simple example, of course, with just one label, but if you combine this with a couple of things like styles, support for dark mode and light mode, you can create your whole kind of own theming engine right here and style your application depending on something, a property that the user sets, and completely style your own application and also have still support for light mode and dark mode. So if I click on this button now, you can see that the hello world changes from fuchsia to red, and you can apply this to any visual element inside of your application. Inside of the file new .NET MAUI application template, there is already a colors.xaml file and a styles.xaml file, which illustrate very nicely how to work with colors and styles. So have a play with that. Try to implement that with static resources, dynamic resources, and play a little bit with, trying to create your own theming engine if that's something that you want. Or maybe, you have this white label app and you want to style your application depending on which customer you're rolling the app out for. That is all things that you can do with the dynamic resources. So go explore. And that's another video wrap for the .NET MAUI 101 series. If there is something else that you want to see for this series in 5 to 10 minutes, please let me know down in the comments. But I already recorded a lot of videos as well. So check out this playlist right here for the other videos. Maybe your subject is already on there. And check out this button to click on the subscribe button so that you're subscribed to my channel and you will find out all the content automatically. See you for the next one.